They are even allowed to not put fragrance in the ingredients list.
Hi guys.
Today I'm at Marina Bay Sands Hotel and I'm here for a staycation. So I was thinking, I'm in a nice hotel room, why not I do a video? So today's video is actually a really important video because I think it's something that people don't really know about. In today's topic, we will be covering how to read product labels. A lot of brands put a lot of effort into packaging because generally the general audience doesn't really know how to read product labels on beauty products especially, and that is really really important because in terms of ingredients wise, there's a lot of brands that add in a lot of unnecessary ingredients that is bad for your skin, that can be irritating for your skin as well, and can also actually make your skin more sensitive than what it actually is. So today will be a very very generic guide on how to read product labels on beauty products so that we can cut all that bullshit. So first things first, what you want to learn how to read would be your concentration levels in the ingredients list. It's a globally known fact that the ingredients that's placed on the product labels that you see are all in concentration levels. So meaning the first ingredient that you see is of the highest concentration, and the concentration at the lowest will be at the last of the list. So this is a very good example. So this is Herbivore Botanicals Phoenix Facial Oil. And when you scroll down to the ingredients, that is basically what you see. So this product has all these ingredients, and the ingredient with the highest concentration is jojoba seed oil over here, which is great for your skin by the way. And at the same time, all the way to the end, it's neroli essential oil. In this case, this is a natural product, and that's why everything that you see here are all quite natural in that sense. There's no synthetics, there's no like there's no chemicals involved over here. So that's the first tip for you guys, which is to find out the concentration levels, and basically what you want is to have good ingredients on the top of the list and bad ingredients not on the list basically. Yeah. The second thing you need to look out for when you are reading labels is how they preserve their skincare products. Anything that you buy that has water, and water would sometimes be called aqua in a lot of the ingredient list, so it requires preservation because water creates a very good environment for bacteria and mold to grow. That's why there's a need for preservatives. And I just wanted to say that there are both natural and synthetic preservatives. It's just that you have to be able to choose the right one. So some of the synthetic ones are really very common. They do not cause that much harm to your skin. What you want to look out for is parabens. So a lot of companies use parabens as their preservative method, and that's what you want to look out for and avoid these products, because parabens are actually one of the key ingredients on like the no-no list. It irritates the skin, it gives allergic reactions, it gives redness to the skin as well. And at the same time, there are some studies that show that parabens actually cause hormonal disruption, which is bad. There are a lot of females in the world that already has their hormones disrupted because of like our menstrual cycle and all of that. Parabens are on the bad side of the spectrum. On the good side of the spectrum, sometimes you will find things like I don't know how to explain this, so I can't really pronounce these words properly, so I'm just gonna list them down over here. These are the ones that are generally found in a lot of skincare products, especially your toners, your emulsions, your your moisturizers and stuff like that. You will definitely be able to find some of this on there. So the third thing you want to learn how to read is basically like Latin terms. But don't worry, these are not like bad stuff. In most cases, all these Latin terms are actually the botanical names that are known globally for a certain flower, a certain herb, a certain plant. And most of the time, these Latin terms are used for extracts or essential oils. Back to our original example of the Herbivore Phoenix Rose Oil. For example, the first one that you see on the list, Simonsia chinensis jojoba seed oil. What this actually means is just the botanical name of jojoba. It's Simonsia chinensis. Yes, basically that's it. For example, all these natural brands, they generally use a lot of natural ingredients, and that's where you'll find a lot of these Latin terms as well. A lot of these brands will actually put in like brackets what the actual well-known mainstream name of this plant is, but if they don't, a very easy solution for you just to pull out that Latin name and just Google it, the global mainstream name will just pop up right away. So the fourth thing you want to look out for is chemicals. So chemicals are very, very, very common. I honestly don't think that there is a need to put a negative connotation on every single chemical that you find on a skincare product, because it's really not very realistic. A lot of these brands, they are essentially a business, and in order to save costs, they cannot use all natural ingredients. And these cost savings actually go back to you guys as cheaper products. That is just how the world works, guys. What you need to make sure is these brands are using the correct chemicals and they are not using bad chemicals that can cause harm to your body in the long term. What you must do is to research on the ingredients list. So I'll probably be doing a video on both good and bad ingredients that you need to look out for, especially in your skincare products. The list is like never ending. So I'm just gonna be pulling out some of the main ones that you definitely can find in a lot of skincare products, especially the cheap ones, which use super, super cheap ingredients, which is most of the time equivalent to like bad ingredients. So look out for that. If you guys haven't subscribed, subscribe down below and get notified when that video comes up. So the fifth thing you need to look out for is fragrance. Fragrance is actually a very, very gray area for many, many companies and many, many brands. So a lot of brands use different words for fragrances. There's perfume, there's aroma as well. So there are so many different terms that brands use to notify the fact that they have fragrance inside your products.
Thank you.
It's already almost 4 p.m. but I haven't had my coffee yet, so. So in some countries, some brands who use fragrance in a super low concentration, they are even allowed to not put fragrance in the ingredients list. So fragrance, in a sense, I've said this quite a few times as well, fragrance causes sensitivity for a lot of people. For you guys who have sensitive skin, you want to just avoid fragrance in general, because generally they irritate the skin. If your skin is on like the more normal side and less sensitive, then most of the time this comes as a bonus, because you get to smell nice products and you get to smell nice things on your face when you put them on. Last but not least, so I think this is like the most important closing point for everybody. So I think most importantly, when you are buying skincare products, you need to know what kind of brand that you are buying from. So a lot of these brands, they have like their motto. So for some brands, it might be vegan friendly, cruelty free, no parabens, no sulfates. So if you are really, really concerned about ingredients, what you want to buy into is a brand that does not sell any chemical products. They only sell 100% natural skincare products. And that's also an option as well. So eventually, buy what you need for your skin. If your skin cannot take any kind of synthetics, any kind of chemicals, then don't touch it at all. So that's all for today's video. This is more or less sufficient for you to learn how to read the labels at a very, very beginner level. So I hope that this was helpful for you guys. If you like this video, please like it and subscribe down below. If you like to find other videos, you guys can find them right here. So as always, thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys next week.